Good morning all. Today the class is on urinary system. So the first you have to know what are the components of the urinary system. The urinary system consists of two kidneys, two ureter, one bladder and urethra. So these are the components of the urinary system. So urinary system consists of two kidneys. We can tell it as a paired kidney, paired urethra, urinary bladder and urethra. These are the components of urinary system. So we'll go in detail with all the components of the urinary system in detail. So the first we'll know the function here. The kidneys remove waste products of the metabolism, excess water and salt from blood and maintain the pH. Then what is the function of ureter is, ureters convey urine from kidney to the urinary bladder. Then the urinary bladder is a muscular reservoir of urine. It is where the storage of urine is will be present, that is urinary bladder. Urethra is the channel to the exterior. So these are what you're looking here is the function of each of the components of the urinary system. Kidney, ureter, urinary bladder and urethra. Okay, now first we'll look into the features. What are the gross features? You look into the first part, that is on the kidney. Okay, what do you mean by kidney? The definition of the kidney. The kidneys are a pair of excretory organ situated on the posterior abdominal wall. See, it is present on the posterior abdominal wall, on one on the each side of the vertebral column behind the peritoneum. So if you look here, so okay. Next, the functions of the kidney. The functions of the kidney are elaborate urine and nitrogenous waste, maintains water electrolyte balance of the body, secretes renin, secrete erythropoietin, that is endocrine function, then secrete 1,25 hydroxycholecalciferol. These are the functions of the kidney. Now, next we'll look into the gross features of the kidney. So we'll look into the external features of the kidney. So when you look into the shape of the kidneys are bean shaped. You can see here the shape of the kidney. The kidneys are bean shaped. It has two poles, upper pole and the lower pole, and two borders, medial and lateral. If you see in the here, see this is the shape of the kidney if you look. Okay, this is the upper pole and this is the lower pole. This is a medial border, this is a lateral border, and this is the anterior surface. Behind it is called as the posterior surface of the kidney. Rule of two. Okay, then next if you look into the upper pole, can you see here? The upper pole is broad and is close in contact with one endocrine gland, that is C, that is called as the suprarenal gland. You can see a gland here. So upper pole is broad and is close contact with corresponding suprarenal gland. Then the lower pole, what you see here? The lower pole is pointed. So this is the gross feature you are looking in the kidney. Upper pole and lower pole of the kidney. Okay, see next. The lateral border. The lateral border is convex. You can see here the lateral border is convex. There is a medial border, if you look, it is concave. You can see here this is the medial border of the kidney. The medial border is concave. The middle part, this is the middle part of the medial border of the kidney. The middle part of medial border is depressed and is known as hilum. You can see this part. This part is where you see hilum. What do you mean by hilum? Hilum is where the structures will enter and leave the kidney. You see, the artery, the vein and ureter are the structure which are related to the hilum of the kidney. So remember, the middle part of the medial border is depressed and is known as hilum. We call it as hilum. What do you mean by hilum? Hilum is where the structures enter and leave the kidney. Next, we'll come to the location, where the location of the kidney is. So first you have to know length. Length is about 11 cm, breadth is about 6 cm, thickness is about 3 cm, weight in male it is about 150 to 170 gram, female 130 to 150 gram. Shape same, bean shape, hilum, this is a hilum what I told you, it is directed medially. Next, we look into coverings of the kidney. So, if you look, the kidney consists of four coverings. So, the four coverings of the kidney are like what it is. What are these? Are each kidney is invested by a following layer from within outwards. So, first the inner part you see that is called as a fibrous capsule. The fibrous capsule is formed by condensation of fibrous connected tissue of the peripheral organ of the kidney. That is a part of the kidney only, condensation of the fibrous connected tissue on the periphery of the organ. So this one, normally, in normal person, kidney, you can easily strip off this fibrous capsule. But in disease condition and all, it becomes adherent to the kidney. So remember, in the kidney, if you look, this is a kidney, okay, from within outward, we are going from inside to out, okay, you'll have a capsule. So that capsule is derived from the fibrous connective tissue. The next you'll be seeing, that is called as a perirenal fat, it is the next, okay, here, this part, consists of collection of fatty tissue around the kidney. You see the fatty tissue around the kidney, that is called a perirenal fat. Outside this, there is one more fascia called a renal fascia. So the renal fascia consists of anterior and the posterior layer. We look in what do you mean by anterior and posterior layer later. Next, outermost you see, which will act as a cushion to the kidney. That is called as a pararenal fat. So pararenal fat consists of fatty tissue. It is more posteriorly placed and form a cushion for the kidney. So it will act as a cushion to the kidney. Okay, that is a pararenal fat. So just know fibrous capsule, perirenal fat, renal fascia and pararenal fat. These are the coverings of the kidney. So we look in the figure here. So see, this is a transverse section of the kidney you are looking. So you can see here, this is a kidney. So the covering you are seeing here, that is called as a fibrous capsule. You can see this is the kidney is covered by capsule. That is called fibrous capsule. Next you are seeing, can you see the yellow color here? That is the fat you are looking, that is called a perinephric fat. Outer to it there is one more here, renal fascia. Outermost this is called as a paranephric fat. Okay, you can see it is more abundant posteriorly, which will act as a cushion to the kidney. This is one more section. Look here, see this is a kidney. Okay. The first you are seeing, the covering. You can see two sections here. One is a transverse section and one more is coronal. So see here, this is the kidney. It is enclosed by capsule. That is called as a fibrous capsule. Okay, this is a fibrous capsule. Then you are seeing a fat here. Can you see the fat here? The dotted one. That is called as a perirenal fat. So this is a dotted one you are seeing. Then the purple color part, what you are seeing, that is called as a renal fascia, which consists of two layers. So anterior layer, you can see anterior layer, it is called as fascia of Talt, and the posterior layer is called as fascia of Zakerkandel. So remember the two fascia there. See, this is the covering. So when you see in the upper pole, it splits and encloses a gland called a suprarenal gland. Whereas the lower pole, it becomes continuous and merges with the peritoneum there. So remember, renal fascia two layer, anterior layer and posterior layer. So dotted one, whatever you are seeing there, they are the fat, okay. So this is a fibrous capsule, perirenal fat, renal fascia and outer part what you are seeing, that is called as a paranephric fat. So there are two sections here, look through the two sections, transverse section and one more is coronal section, to explain the coverings of the kidney. Okay, next, relation and the parts, two surfaces, anterior, behind, posterior, border, medial and lateral, two poles, upper and the lower poles. Okay, now we have to learn what are the relation of the anterior surface of the kidney. So the anterior surface of the kidney, the relation are different on the right and the left side. This is the right kidney and this is the left kidney. So the right kidney anterior surface is related to, you can see here, first upper part, right suprarenal gland. Next, if you look, that is the this part here, that is called, is related to duodenum, that is related to second part of the duodenum. Then this region is related to hepatic area, that is relation to liver. Then this is related to jejunal area. Then this one is related to colic area. Jejunal means the small intestine. The colic area, it is related to hepatic flexure of colon. So if we draw a kidney, the first part, this part is related to suprarenal gland, mentioned right suprarenal gland. The hilum part is related to second part of duodenum. Hepatic area related to liver. Jejunal area, the small intestine. Colic area, the right flexure of colon. This is on right kidney. Next, left kidney. Left kidney is related to upper part. It is related to left suprarenal gland. Next, the gastric area, which is related to the stomach. The splenic area related to spleen. Then the pancreatic area. Jejunal area, the small intestine. Colic area for left colic flexure. Okay. These are the left side kidney. So the left side kidney, if you look, it is related to suprarenal gland. Okay. Splenic area, gastric area for small intestine. This is a pancreatic area, colic area and jejunal area. These are the relation, that is the anterior relation of the left kidney. Then this is about the posterior surface of the left, both, okay, right and left. The relation are same, the only difference is the right kidney is related to 11th and the 12th. The right kidney is related to only to the 12th rib, whereas the left kidney, it is slightly higher up, so it is related to 11th and the 12th rib. This is the same relation of the right and the left kidney. Okay, posterior relation, draw the diagram. Then tell the ribs on the right side, it is related to only 12th. Left, it is related to higher up, so 11th and 12th. Next, it is related to diaphragm. Both side, right and left. The next, it is related to three nerves there. The nerves are first nerve, subcostal nerve. Next is iliohypogastric. And the next, ilioinguinal nerve. Muscles. The muscle, it is related to psoas major, quadratus lumborum and transverse abdominis. So these are the posterior relation of both right and the left kidney. Diaphragm, 3 nerve, subcostal nerve, iliohypogastric nerve and ilioinguinal nerve. The muscle are psoas major, quadratus lumborum and transverse abdominis. Coming to the next part, where you're looking the structure of the kidney, that is a macroscopic structure of the kidney, where we have taken the coronal section of the kidney. So in the coronal section of the kidney, if you look, it consists of two parts. The two parts are outer the region, this is called as a cortex, the inner part, this part is called as a medulla. So the outer reddish brown cortex, the inner pale, called as the medulla. So what you look here is the coronal section of the kidney shows outer reddish brown part, that is called as a cortex, the inner pale part, which is called as a medulla. When you look into the medulla consists of conical mass. You can see here the conical mass, which are pyramidal in shape. These are called as the pyramids. You see this one, conical mass, like they are called as the renal pyramids. So So their apex, these are the apex, forms the renal papillae. So this forms the renal papillae, which will project into the calyx part, which will project into, you can see here, projecting into minor calyx. So the apex of it will project into the minor calyx. Okay. Each papillae, this is formed by, each of these papillae is formed by 2 to 4 pyramids. Then in between the pyramid, the region what you look here, they are called as the renal columns. The part what you see here, they are called as the renal columns. So in the macroscopy structure, you see cortex, medulla. The medulla consists of renal pyramids, the apex of it here, which will be opening into the minor calyx. Look here, an outer reddish brown cortex, the inner pale medulla consisting of renal pyramids, and between the adjacent pyramid are the renal columns. A space, the space between is called as a renal sinus. Next you are looking the blood supply. The blood supply to the kidney will come from the branches arising from the aorta. It is called as abdominal aorta. The abdominal aorta gives branches. The branches are called as a renal artery. You can see the artery, renal artery. So the abdominal aorta, the branches are right and left renal artery. The right renal artery is longer compared to left renal artery. The venous drain, the renal vein will drain into the vena cava. This is a, what you're looking, that is called as the inferior vena cava. So the arterial branch, they come from abdominal aorta, the veins will drain, they are called a renal vein, drain into inferior vena cava. So see, these are all the branches, what you look, all the branches coming from it. So this the renal artery. The renal artery will divide into branches reaching into hilum of the kidney. So branches are anterior, coming in front, posterior branches. So these branches will again divide into segments when reaching the kidney. Then it divide further into each lobe. Okay, they are called a lobar, then into interlobar, then divide further. You can see the smaller branches here. They are called as the arcuate branches. Arcuate arteries. Then the interlobular artery will give rise to efferent glomerular arteriole, glomerular capillaries, efferent glomerular arteriole. All this will drain into vein called as a renal vein. सो दीज आर वॉट द ब्रांचेस. ओके, इंटरलोबार, द आर्कुएट आर्टरीज, दैट इज अबाउट द किडनी. सो इन द किडनी यू हैव टू लर्न अबाउट द कवरिंग्स ऑफ द किडनी, द फोर कवरिंग्स देर, द फाइबरस कैप्सूल, पेरी रीनल, रीनल फेशिया एंड द पैरा रीनल फैट. ओके, देन प्रैक्टिस विद द डायग्राम. देन द रिलेशन ऑफ द किडनी, anterior relation and posterior. Anterior relation is different on the right and the left side of the kidney. Then learn about the posterior relation of right and the left kidney. The only difference is right is related to 12th, where because of the presence of liver, okay, it is pushed downwards, whereas in the left it is related to 11th and the 12th rib. Okay, next we'll look into ureter. Definition: the ureter is a pair of narrow, thick-walled muscular tubes which convey urine from kidney to urinary bladder. It is a tube, okay, which conveys the urine from kidney to the urinary bladder. See, this is the tube you are looking. So it conveys the urine from kidney to urinary bladder. The important thing to know about in ureter are the constrictions of the ureter. The ureter consists of three constriction, okay. So they are the commonest site where the stone get lodged up. So the constriction of the ureter are one at the beginning, that is this one, at pelvic ureter. You can see number one there, at pelvic uretric junction or uretropelvic junction where you see sudden constriction of the ureter, that is called at uretropelvic junction. Then the next you see at crossing, you can see at crossing of external or common iliac artery, this is the next constriction. The third constriction at the site or opening into the urinary bladder. These are the three constriction of the ureter: one at pelvic uretric junction, next at the lesser pelvis, brim of the lesser pelvis, where it is crossed by common iliac artery. The third, the opening into the urinary bladder, or you can tell at the site of entrance of the urinary bladder. These are the three constriction, which is a commonest site for site of obstruction and stone impaction. Blood supply to it, ureter, is from branches coming from the abdominal aorta. So you can see direct branch coming from abdominal aorta, or from coming from the renal artery, or from the artery, one more, from the abdominal aorta branch only, that is called as a middle rectal artery, one more is a vesicular artery. These are the arterial branch, artery supplying the ureter. Renal artery, all these are branches of from the abdominal aorta only. Renal, aorta, vesicular and middle rectal arteries. Ureter, in the ureter you have to learn main thing about the constrictions of the ureter. Okay, that the three constrictions are very important to know about the ureter. Okay, this is about today's class. Thank you.